I think we have to take Guppy's tail here. Hangman, no good. Go check for our secret room. I think it's over here. Mystery sack's good. Yes, but it has nothing to do with that, Timoas. Guppy's tail makes more chests spawn as rewards from clearing stuff. Super secret's likely over here. I kind of want to save my bombs, though, so we'll wait. Oh, also, another thing that Book of Shadows is good for is, if you do take damage inside a cursed room, you can actually get out without ending your run. Solar 123789, thank you for the 6 consecutive months, sir. Appreciate it. Much love. No, I think I'm good there. Think we're good. Curse of the Maze. Let's just get Curse of the Maze out of here. Destruction Rune could be good. No, there's not a sack transformation. Magician's okay. Hoping for a good room full of mushrooms to use this on. Dark rock there, I don't really want to use it. Okay, this is a scary item, but also powerful. This is an okay candidate for the Destruction Rune, but definitely not the best. Destruction Rune destroys all rocks and stuff inside a room, so it'd blow up all these mushrooms. Ship, okay. Definitely gonna look for in the stores here because we could get PhD, which would be nice. Jar of Flies is pretty decent, but no, we need another companionship room, my goodness. This is probably the best room to use the Destruction Rune in. We're gonna clear the floor to make sure, though. All stat up mushroom would certainly be nice. We're rocking no damage or tears up so far going into Caves 1. I need to reboot my game real quick. One sec. Okay, much better. Well, let's go back. Secret room's likely there. We'll see. It's looking like it. Any setup would be great right about now. Gotta be careful on those bombs. They're very powerful. I like dimes. Dimes are good. No, I still have to find the shovel, Wretched. That was to unlock the shovel. We have to find the shovel on a run to get Replatinum God. But we have all the requirements now, so it'll show up eventually. Ooh, lordy. At the very latest, it'll show up when we break the game one time. Well, we're gonna risk it for a biscuit here. Okay, at least we got our key back. Two room. That rerolls all the consumables in this room only. So we might as well drop stuff in here. You never know. No pills on the floor yet, though we can use the destruction rune to get those mushrooms. They'll probably drop pills. Should. Do, do, do. Alright, we'll use bombs for these. Whoa, that's right, I got big old bombs. Forgot about that. Actually, I wonder... Let's go ahead and use bombs in here instead. I wonder if one bomb, like, right about here would get most of them. I gotta wonder if Dead Center's gonna get them all. Let's see. It did! Probably want to save the destruction rune. I'd think. Rothman909, little hand to you, friend. Welcome to the Dapper, Rothman. Appreciate the support, dude. Much love. Doo-doo-doo. We'll keep the destruction rune. Gonna go ahead and bomb these urns though, in case they have coins. It's not a coin. It is a dark rock, I don't care. Dark rocks are not good here. The best I can get out of a small rock is the small rock, which is just the speed down for me right now. Soul hearts don't matter. No, it does not. It's Rune. Could have been better, could have been a lot worse. Check and see if there's a key in the store. That'd be good. We'll use a bomb here in hopes for keys. Oh, okay. It is a speed down, which is bad, but at the same time, it is a damage and tier rate up, which I sorely needed. No keys. Hey, Stain! How you doing, partner? How's life? Okay. Speed seemed to remain about the same. Looks like we got tier rate up. I'll bet we got a health down, which is ideal. Do I take the destruction rune or keep the purity rune? I think I'm gonna keep purity rune. All right, going down. I sorely need some speed here, but we're gonna be okay. Trickle charge actually pretty good. We get two room charge, Book of Shadows. It's pretty safe. And that's why we took the purity rune, because F Curse of Darkness. Yeah, it looks like overall damage went up from that. That's good. This Caves 2, we don't want to do the Bloody Combat Room Caves 2 unless we get a teleportation item to get out of here. This would have been a prime candidate for the Destruction Rune as well, but we're going to be alright. One bomb will clear the sides here. What's up, Netarchy? Good to see you. Yay, key. That room's actually completely safe since you can hang out over the mushrooms. Same thing with this one, it's totally safe, I just gotta hang out over the gaps. Oh god, why? Why'd you do that, sir? Explain yourself. I did that to myself, too. I dodged right into that one. Alright. Well, we'll start back over. It was fun while it lasted. I feel like I could have won that run, too. It's a bummer. That's okay. You win some, you lose some. If you won them all, the game wouldn't be fun. Alright, guys. Give me a second. This is not an ad break. I'm just going to step away for a sec. Alrighty. I believe I missed Bewildered Chicken. Thanks for your 10 months of support, sir. Greatly appreciate it. You know what? Let's switch gears here. We'll start a new streak next week's broadcast. I'm going to play some Meat Boy because it's been a while. And I kind of want to do a 106% run. I give a little hand gesture there because I'll probably it'll probably be closer to 105%. So I'll miss something. It's been a while. Glad you feel that way, Rothman. Thanks for being here, sir. I was actually thinking about Meat Boy last night and how it's been a while since I played. So I'm gonna go ahead and mute my desktop audio here because this game is infamously loud on startup. You guys will have it here in just a sec. No, don't stop working though. Okay, hold on. Now I gotta find my save real quick. Let's see. C, program files 86, Steam, Steam apps, common, Super Meat Boy, user data, save game.dat, get deleted. Tom Sweden, thank you for the 24 consecutive months, sir. Much love, man. Much love. 2 frickin' years. What a player. Well, we have 610 hours on Meat Boy. That's crazy. Think I may like this game. Okay. Add window capture. Super Meat Boy. Capture cursor? No. Yeah, almost 16 by 9. Close. So, I'm going to get in the game here, then I'll unmute. Stats are down. Alright, how is the gain to voice volume right here? Yeah, dollar per hour. I think we got there. I got this game on Steam sale a very long time ago. Very long time ago. Good volume? Okay, cool. It's a little bit louder inside the levels. I'm hopping off camera, I'm just gonna pull off my hoodie real quick, and then we'll do this. Because this game makes me sweat, and I know that. Alrighty. It's been a while. Let's see how we're playing today. Whoopsie daisy. We gotta collect all bandages. We're going 106%, so here we go. Asol93, thank you for keeping it dapper. Appreciate the 2 years of support, man. And all your other support. Appreciate you, dude. Much love. Sounds good, Fishhook. Whoops, a little bit off on that one. Speedrun? Not really, just playing fast. I have speedrun this game in the past, but we're definitely out of practice. It's like riding a bike, that's right. Gotta get used to using the D-pad again, too. I've been using the joystick for Isaac pretty much exclusively. Looking good, feeling good. Close. We got it. Thanks to the host Thrax, appreciate it. I prefer the D-pad for Meat Boy. I can't say it's better, that's just my preference. A lot of people say that, Zagman. I love it. I think the D-pad's great for the 360 controller. To each their own, I say. What zone is this? Oh, Commander Vidya. You'll have your time to shine later, sir. Speaking of which, Bitip Runner. I'm probably going to play that again sometime, too. I love that game. Yeah, the world record uses a lot of stuff that I just can't do. I never really played to try to get a world record. I played kind of within my own parameters. Hey, thank you, Leprechaun. Appreciate you using that Amazon affiliate. One of the easiest ways to support the broadcast. Much love, man. Nice, Chozgob. I don't know, something about the original Bit Trip I like more than 2. It's not because it's a better game, though. Whoops. Whoopsie daisy. There we go. A plus bandage. Nice. It's one of the harder levels to execute. Definitely the hardest level in the forest to get the A plus and bandage in the same run. With certainty. Warp zone! Nice, Smurf. Ooh, Game Boy Warp Zone. Nice thing about doing 106% is you get to see a lot of levels that you don't otherwise. The Warp Zones are pretty cool in this game. Done goofed it. Briskerain is pretty brutally hard. No argument from me there. Nice. Whoa! What was that? That was a weird graphical glitch there. Good evening, Duxon. What's happening, dude? Well, I almost died there, man. Do, do. 106% requires A pluses for the light worlds, Gold Vanderhood, because you need A plus on each light world to unlock the dark world. You, however, do not need A pluses on the dark worlds. Duxon MX, thank you for keeping it dapper. Appreciate the year of support, man. To the hospital. Rogue Legacy is a good game for sure. No pinball tonight. We have, one of the final Kickstarter meetings for people that contributed. 1,500 or more for the Kickstarter gets 2 meals cooked by me, and we get to hang out on during the weekend. So that's happening this weekend. So I broke down the pinball studio tonight. to make sure everything was clean and set up. God bless America. There we go. Pinball will return next week, though. Okay, we gotta replay that level. Nice! Flippity floppity, hippity hoppity. Same artist, Luigi and Tails, Evan McMillan, or Isaac and Meat Boy. Oh yeah, it's the Jill Warp Zone, okay. Use Jill a few times in different levels. Whoops. There we go. We got there. I kind of feel like I've missed a warp zone. I don't know, though. If we did, we did. This is casual 106%, which means it's probably going to end up being 105. Yeah, Meat Boy soundtrack is definitely one of the greats. Some of Danny Baranowski's best work. That's saying something. Thanks for the host, Jinxkins. Appreciate it. Different characters have different abilities. Huntworthy is how it works. Yeah, okay, Timonis. Well, we'll definitely die 100 times in a 106% run. Let me go ahead and just guarantee that for you. And you unlock different characters by doing the warp zones or by collecting bandages. So by progressing, you technically do. Whoopsie daisy. Technically do. Well, thanks, Tasmus. I enjoy playing this game. We don't play it as much as we used to, but it's still fun. Still very fun. This level's a pain. So the bandage is all the way at the bottom, which means that you have to go here and then go all the way back, and then you have to do the level again to get your A+. Well, it's definitely a time sink. Oh my goodness, I almost died, man. Yeah, I have Inch. Indie game, the movie. What's in here? There's a warp zone here, right? There it is. Thanks for the host, Firehawk. I didn't miss warp zone yet. Thanks, Love Wizard. Appreciate it. So some warp zones have two bandages in them, which is a key requirement for getting 106%. Oops, I goofed. Bandage back over here. Budgems. I don't think we're gonna get the A+ here, unfortunately. Maybe? Hey, we got it! There's a super clutch way you can get that bandage. We're not gonna do that, because it's way too hard. What you do is cheese your jump into, well, you go back, you go backwards. It saves about 4 seconds. We're just gonna do it the old way. Because it's way safer to do it this way. The downside is you, have to come back and get your A+. Warble still has the 80%? Yeah, that was a hell of a run. I think we're gonna get the A+, unless I do that. I get there? About a half second off. That's okay. Played Fez for one night. And one night only. My best time was like 2 hours and 15 minutes. That was before a lot of the really aggressive skips were found, though. I think at the time I had that run, the world record was currently at about 140, somewhere around there. 137, maybe? Oops, gotta go back. Gotta go back and get that A+, buddy. We need that. Because there's the dark world to do as well, FVK. I said the exact same thing. I go back and get the A+ too. My goodness. My goodness. What's up, Meliscar? Noise. Okay, we skip this, so I'm gonna come back to it in the dark world. All right, J.R. Barnes, have a great one, sir. Thanks for hanging out, man. Well, let's get this and we'll redo the level for the warp. All right, Rob's this one. Do 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 do. Have a great one, Zagman. Easy money. Alright, Killer Cantaloupe. Thanks again for your support, man. We'll catch you next time. Oh yeah, this is where we use Jill. This one is a nightmare. Well, the third level on this one is, I think, the hardest bandage to get the entire game. It's pretty pixel perfect. It's a bunch of baloney. Or, you know, I can just nail it. That's cool, too. Sure. Just that good, I guess. Bad. First try, sure. That totally wasn't luck at all. Don't believe what you read. Oh, I'm dead. Or I'm not. Man, I missed the A+, though. I mis-executed on the end there. Yeah, I don't think I'll ever get tired of the soundtrack either, Gritty. It's a good one. It's a damn good one. There's a bandage here? Yes. Doesn't really matter, we would have had to do the level twice anyways. Once for the bandage, one for the A+. So that works out all good. Enjoy your lurking, Rothman. Lurkers number one. Yeah, I watched a bit of that Farabomb. It's got a good soundtrack, don't get me wrong. I think it's one of those cases, though, where, like, this is, in my opinion, like, one of the best indie game soundtracks ever. So it's really hard to, really hard to surpass, even with a really good soundtrack like the PlayStation 4 Meat Boy has. You're always going to compare it to this one, and it's always going to come up a little bit short. I only take it 106% the first time, probably about 10 hours on the run. I think you should, Noliscar. Merch is good. Speaking of merch, we have a super robust merch shop. I think the biggest on Twitch. Not just frag merchandise, we also got pinball shirts, programming shirts, and all sorts of other shenanigans on there. All very reasonably priced. I'm actually using the joystick right now, which I've never done before. It's working out okay. What's up, Dart Zombie? How you doing, man? Awesome, Agent 86. Well, thanks for stopping by before bed, man. Appreciate you, sir. Yes, sir. Oh, come on, Ogbro. Ogbro, please. Dogma is used in a couple of levels. 418 is definitely the biggest one. Or 419? 418. I hear you there, Darth. It's been a really long day, and we got a long weekend ahead of us, but I'm excited for it. Hey, awesome, Meliscar. Yeah, those pinball shirt designs are really nice. Yes, we deliberately skip four and come back with it when we have a double jump character, a la the kid. You could do it with Ogmo, but you don't get the A plus and bandage. By using the kid, you get the A plus and bandage. A plus and bandage in the same run. Yeah, Ogmo is outclassed by the kid, but he is a good replacement until you get him. Nice. We're getting all the easy levels done right now. Believe it or not. Yeah, we got there. That's a really hard A plus bandage to get. I think the cutoff is 20 seconds. It's usually within half a second if you get it or not. Well, if you do use the tweeter, Meliscar, send me a tweet of you wearing the shirt when you get it. I always appreciate that stuff. Yes, sir. Flippity floppity hippity hoppity. Alright, cool. I am Lethalfrag and everything. YouTube, Twitter, Facebook. Always at Lethalfrag. Okay, back to the D-pad. Joystick's okay, but it doesn't give me the same control I want. Kersoon, thank you for keeping a tab for the past 2 months, sir. Appreciate it. Thank you, thank you. It's a great level for Ogmo here. This one feeds right to Ogmo's strengths, which is sideways jumping. He's the champ at that. He is a double jump character, but he does do very good side. He has good horizontal movement on his jumps. Well, Ange, I don't consider myself the most naturally gifted game player, to be honest. What it really comes down to is I play games as part of my job, so having 600 hours in this game makes me look good. But I was terrible when I first started playing it, too. I have the luxury of being able to play and practice games that I want to get good at. I'm one of those people that if you give me enough time with something, I can and will get good at it, but I definitely have to make the time commitment, you know? Okay, there's a hidden warp zone here. I'm glad I remembered it. It's under these. Warp zone! Like, I look really good at Isaac, but that's the result of 3,000 hours of playing. Yeah, watch the Mexican run. He makes me feel bad about how good I am at games. Mm. my god, I don't want to die, I want to die! We didn't die, yay! That's a tough one for the timing. This level, on the other hand, is, you can cheese it. Cheese it. That's right. Not usually JWP. I think I am lucky in how I've always played video games has been... I play video games on stream like I like to play video games if I was not a streamer. I like to get very good at the games I do play, but I generally don't play, like, a huge variety of games. I was never into buying, like, all the new titles when I, you know, used to play and stuff. I'd be like, okay, well, I'm gonna play Call of Duty, so, you know, that's what I play. Or this is a cool game, let me drop 500 hours into it. Which isn't really the norm, but it does save quite a bit of money. I inherently have a very addictive personality, and that certainly shows through in my video game play as well. Some people find playing the same games boring. I find it relaxing and soothing. You know what, guys? I think I'm gonna play the COD campaign next week on stream if I get around to it. I think it's gonna happen at some point. Well, I haven't played the campaign. I played a little bit of the multiplayer, but I think that'd be a fun little thing. I don't play shooters very often on stream, but I've been itching to play a little bit. I probably did miss an A+, but if we did, we'll know, because we'll have to go back and get it when we do the Dark Worlds. We got a warp zone in here. We'll be back for that. There we go. I think as a broadcaster, you really have to be able to enjoy repetitive tasks, because if you don't enjoy repetitive tasks, it's going to be really hard to grind out as much content. In my opinion. I mean, I've played like 190-something games over my four-year career, which really isn't that much in retrospect, but, you know, the games I do enjoy, I have many, many thousands of hours. There you go, Mr. Meat. Yeah, I haven't seen it either, Gigabits Gaming. Which one is it? This one? I think this one? There we go. There's a bandage on one of those blocks. Gotcha. Honestly, if you're not enjoying the game you're playing as a broadcaster, it really sucks. Like, it's pretty harsh. Even worse, if you stop playing a game halfway through because you're not enjoying it, everybody just gives you shit for quitting the game halfway through. That's an even worse feeling. But you gotta do what you gotta do. Okay, no A+, right. I have literally no way to answer that question, though, Wizard. I don't have a plan. Nor do I want to have a plan. Plans are stupid. They lead to expectations, which leads to disappointment every single time. All right, Ogmo, it's your time to shine again. Okay, we just missed out on our A+. That's okay, though. Oh, never mind. Oh, this game definitely drew some inspiration from it, for sure. Star Zombie. What? I went under that one? Whoa. Oh, I done goofed. You done goofing on, bro. There we go. Plans are stupid. Making plans as a broadcaster, I have never had work out well for me. As far as games go. Not once has it worked out the way I wanted it to. Mick Minifus, thank you for keeping it damper. Appreciate the 2 consecutive months. Much love. The road to hell is paved with good intentions. Actually, a very fantastic quote, and true. Very true. You want my best advice for what games to stream? Play what you want, when you want, and make no apologies. I missed A+ on 9. That's okay. We'll be back for it with the Dark Worlds. Pretty cool game, actually, Inch. A bit dated as far as platforming goes, but good game. Very visually pleasing game for sure. Crimson Umbrella, I felt the platforming and combat was a bit frustrating, but the actual visuals of the game were pretty impressive. I didn't finish that one either, about halfway through, three quarters. It definitely feels dated, because it's an older game, but definitely hits that Alice in Wonderland mystical feel for sure. Hot diggity dog. Alright guys, before we head into the Rapture, I'm going to take a quick break. I need to use the restroom. When we return, we're going to slam and jam all the way across the galaxy. We'll be right back. Yes, I have Cheesy Bob. It's a fun game for sure. It's a good one. Yeah, it had a lot of problems, Smurfizzle. Though, if you played Alice Madness Returns the day it released, that was probably one of the most mind-blowing games ever released for its time. Like, straight up, it was really good. It's a good game, just in comparison to what we have now, It definitely falls short. Be right back. Alright, we're back. Thanks for your patience. What's happening, 72? Let's do a lurker roll call. If you're lurking in the chat and you're able, post yourself a frag lurk. Where are my lurkers at? I know you're out there, lurking, waiting. Hi, Winston. You gonna help out, bud? Give me a good boy. Be a good boy. Look at all those lurkers, dear God. You all are beautiful. Beautiful people. Lurkers are so great. Lurkers are the best. Lurkers enable this amazing chat environment. Oh yeah, I got due to like the worst warp zone in the game. Forgot about that. This next one comes. This is the longest warp zone in the game. It's a difficult one, too. This is definitely where a speedrun can go to die. Graham, we're not running on a timer, but I've definitely dropped a few urns in this warp zone. This is like 5 times longer than any other warp zone in the game. Hey, Dad, quick question, where's the water go? Where's it go, though, Dad? What? Okay, we made it. Kid Warp Zone's not the... Well, maybe it's the hardest Warp Zone, but it's certainly not the longest. This is so by far the longest Warp Zone. Alright, Ange, have a great time with Fallout 4. Hope you enjoy it. Lord Vexus, little hand to you, friend. Welcome to the dapper Lord Vexus. Can we get some hands in the air for Lord Vexus? Appreciate you, sir. Got there. One more level. We'll just slow roll this one. We'll do slow strats. Ooh, done goof that one. Do 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 do. He's a lurker. What a legend. As I was saying, lurkers enable this amazing chat environment to happen. Oh, please don't die one more time, please. If I die this time, we have to do the entire thing again. Levels 1, 2, and 3, so I'd really prefer not to do that. Here we go again. Here we go again.
Warp Zone!
Warp Zone! Been a long time since I failed that one. I'm just not, well, I'm rusty at Meat Boy, and that's fine. There was a time in my career where I mained this game for like weeks on end. Those times are long gone. I still very much enjoy playing it though. We'll get there. Oh yeah, now I remember my strat. It's all coming back to me. Always needs more Peppa. On a good note, if you can get through this warp zone, you can get through just about anything. There's definitely some very hard levels, but... That's A-okay. Good luck, have fun, Cortez. It's a dangerous item. Do 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 So after we complete the rapture, then we have the end, which is technically the end of any percent. Then we have Cotton Alley, and then we have Dark Worlds for all of them. And after that, we've completed our quote-unquote 106%. It'll probably be 105%, because I would not be surprised if I missed a bandage or warp zone somewhere. It happens. This one we definitely didn't miss, though. They make this one painfully obvious where it is, so you have to do it. Ha! Okay, we made it down there, that's good. It's 106% because there are 6 glitch levels in this game. They're intentionally there, but it's a random chance to get it. It's one of the only RNG things in this entire game are the glitch levels. After completing the light worlds, you have a chance to get, I think it's a 3% chance to get Glitch Girl at the end of your level. If you touch Glitch Girl, you get the glitch world. Yay! And each glitch level counts for 1%. Where did I miss a bandage in a warp zone, Rock Demon? We made it, nice. First time I saw that strat, it blew my frickin' mind. Yes, you can't, oh balls. You can get every bandage playing as Meat Boy. Actually, no, that's not true. You do need a double jump character to get one of them. Whoops, I just done goofed. Not supposed to press the button, sir. The 3-4 bandage requires a double jump character to get. You can't complete all levels with Meat Boy. You cannot collect all bandages as Meat Boy. That's how it goes. Or I should say, A-plus is available on all levels with Meat Boy. Here we go, the Kid Warp Zone. So this level took me a good, I think 2.5 hours to beat the first time. Once you understand it though, it's not as bad. Don't get me wrong, it's still very tough, but once you understand how to make the spike jumps there, it's not as bad. This one, on the other hand, always a bit tricky. Little trick for this level, you can time your movements to the music. As in, the platforms are definitely synced to where the music is. Or, you know, we'll one-shot it. Dovicento, thank you for keeping it dapper. Appreciate the 5 consecutive months, sir. Much love. we got there. No, thank you, DaVinzo. Thank you. Takes so many people to make this channel full-time. I appreciate each and every one of you that does your part, whether you just spend time watching, you subscribe, support affiliates, buy merch, so on and so forth. It really does take a lot of stuff to make this channel work. So thank you everybody that does, has any part in it. I greatly appreciate it. It's a real blessing to be able to do this for a living, and I try to make the most out of every day. I think that's the least I can do for the support that I get. Show up on time, try to be in a good mood. Living the dream, baby. It hurts so good. There we go. Where did you come from, dude? Calm your shit. Why am I even going this way? I'm gonna die. Let's go this way. You can cheese this one with a kid, but I'm used to doing it normal style, so. I guess it's not really cheese, it's just easy. I don't think so. I think, actually, I want to be the boss who was released long before Meat Boy. It's more invisible. Yeah, little meat monsters can be very trolly, for sure. Whoa! That bomber, though. What a guy. Did I get there? I got there. Nice. Yeah, I'll be doing our Bashi run starting December 23rd. Warp Zone! Not going to do a practice run or anything this year. We beat the game in about 8 hours. Last time, so we're going to go into it blind with an entire year off. Waters Rush, little hand to you, friend. Welcome back to the Dapper, Waters Rush. Appreciate the continued support, man. Good to see you back. Balls. Balls. We got the bandage, though. That's good, right? That's good, right? That is correct. We did 731 days consecutive streaming the 2-year live stream challenge. Went from January 5th, 2012 to January 6th, 2014 without missing a day. And we averaged about 7 hours a night over that 731 day period. We started playing Bashi in December and we managed to beat Solgrin on Christmas morning. Thanks, Waters Rush. Turbo's great, dude. Turbo's such a good feature. Should probably renew my Turbo. I don't know. I've been like half debating if I should or not. I like Turbo a lot, but I don't mind watching the ads, and I just don't watch that many streams. Meat Boy is a boy without skin, Zorian. Turbo is great though, fantastic feature. So what Turbo does, it makes sure you'll never see an advertisement on the site, but in addition to that, the broadcasts that you watch will have a 100% ad fill rate. That means anytime they play an advertisement, they receive full credit for that ad, which is not really feasible because the way advertisements work is, it's based off of seasonality and location. So the odds of a broadcaster having a 100% ad fill rate when they play an ad is zero. So it's a good way to support the site and the broadcast as you watch. In order for Turbo to count, you do have to remove your ad blocker or whitelist Twitch after having Turbo on. Otherwise, the broadcasters you watch will not receive credit. Consider it an ethical ad blocker that also supports the people that you watch. I have absolutely nothing against Adblock. I think Adblock is a really good thing because there's a lot of very malicious advertisements out there and a lot of really scary shit out there on the internet that Adblocker does block, and I think that's a good thing. However, as a content producer, Adblocker kind of sucks because I would say close to 90% of people that watch Twitch use Adblocker, which means it's very hard to make money off of advertisements, which makes doing this to a living even harder than it already is. That being said, I never judge. It's each person's choice whether they want to watch ads or not. It's none of my business. Bevins, little hand to you, friend. Welcome to the Dapper Bevins. Do appreciate it. Much love. Much love. How you doing today, Solomaron? What's good, dude? Yeah, buddy. Oh yeah, let's use Jill here. It makes it a lot easier. What? I missed the bandage? Okay, I believe it. There we go. Slide on in. Okay, we missed the A+ there, unfortunately. Simple is good, Solomon. Simple is good. The goofs, though. You're done goofing, Jill. Truth be told, this game got me through one of my worst depression periods during the 2-year livestream challenge. Hey, cheers, Bevins. I'm glad you've been enjoying the content, and thank you for working me into your budget. I appreciate it. I will indeed keep it up. We are show number 1229 as of tonight. I've not been late or missed a day yet. The least I can do. You keep watching, I'll keep streaming. I'll wait for this one. We're just gonna wait. This one has a pretty generous A+ time. Pretty hard not to get the A+. Yeah, buddy. Do. Awesome, Naruki. That's actually a really cool project. We missed A+ up here. Let's go back and get it. Oh yeah. Okay, that makes sense. Nice, Waters Rush. Nice. New hardware is always really exciting. I got my dream PC right now. My dream casting PC, that is. I'm excited because now I'll finally be able to save some money. We've invested in all our super intense hardware and the pinball machines and all the stuff to capture those and the PC for doing all that stuff. Finally gonna be able to save something. That feels good. 70 plus games. I didn't realize that was that many Star Wars games. I guess that, yeah, I guess if you're going all the way back, that that's about right. All right, time for the end. I love the end. I think the one, the music's great. That is Larry Sr., Madly Bored. Crunch Tooth, little hand to you, friend. I want to say that's a welcome back to the Dapper Crunch Tooth. If I'm wrong, pardon me. Name looks very familiar, though. Thank you very much, Crunch Tooth. Yeah, who knows, Nuriki? Maybe those educational games might do you well. You never know. Lots of new subs tonight. Greatly appreciate it, guys. Much love. It is a welcome back. Yeah, nailed it. I knew it. I knew it. Welcome back, dude. The end music is fantastic. The level design's really good. The levels are hard as nails, but I feel that these levels, after you have achieved a level of not mastery in this game, but you know you're decent, these levels feel very good to execute. Making really good speed here. We got it. Yeah, we got it. The quick way. Yoink. I'm out of here. Woo! That felt good. I can only hit the really fast way about 1 out of 10 times I do these levels, so nice. Or that level specifically, I've always struggled on. Alright, we'll go slow. Out of 10, stuck the landing. Ooh, that was my fault. That was my fault. It's the nice thing about this game. It's always your fault. Nope. Good morning, Karma War. I always slow down on this part because I'm always fearful of killing myself after doing all that work. Dr. Fetus, meet Tornado. So you complete this level in a way that's unintended. You're not supposed to be able to get past the that little wall of spikes, but you can. Wow, Karma War, that's gotta feel good. The day you have kids is the day you realize how little sleep you need. You certainly do appreciate when you get to sleep in, that's for sure. Yeah, I ran 106% for a while, Madly Bored, but I have no desire to do so now. I had to practice for weeks on end to even get back to close to where I was. This is the only game I've ever attempted to speedrun or wanted to. And I really did so for my personal best not to have a world record. It's just a game I wanted to get better at, and I certainly did. Whoa! Do, 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 do. Kids are great, Bevins. I will say there's absolutely nothing wrong with not wanting children. You should never feel required to have children, but I will say becoming a father is probably the best thing I've ever done in my life. I would not be here broadcasting if I did not have a child, because it made me realize I wanted to do something more, which led to me doing the 2-year live stream challenge. And that was a pretty huge motivator through the whole thing. What's up, Tig Newtons? Wuggy, good to see ya. Now I get to do Cotton Alley, and Cotton Alley is, it's an adventure. Cotton Alley is one of the few where the dark worlds many times are actually easier than the light worlds. Definitely not true in every case, but some of these light world levels are nutty. Oh yeah, kids are very expensive too. Super expensive. Oh yeah, for sure, Bevins. It's definitely an overwhelming thing to think about. There's nothing, shouldn't feel bad about that. The huge responsibility. Yep, indeed they are, Karma. Indeed they are. I can't think of a better way to spend money, though, than on your kids. The second you realize how to do this slowly, you feel stupid, because you've been trying to go through that middle portion the entire time. Happened to me. Yeah, I play Cloudberry Kingdom, Crunch Tooth. He was ready for me though. I hear you, Wogie. I have a ridiculously long way to go to be saving. The past 4 years of my life have been incredibly expensive, but that is not a complaint. I'm in a great place. I actually now have to start saving so I can maybe retire one day, but I managed to do the whole thing debt-free, and that's really amazing. Oh hey, I got deaded there, man. There we go. That's how we do it. Cool, J.R. Barnes. Welcome to the club, man. A very long way away from retirement. Very long way. And I ain't sad about it either. I'm loving life right now. I don't think I'll be in any hurry to retire either. As my dad always says, those that retire early, die early. You gotta keep yourself busy. It is breakfast kittles. I'm very proud of that. I'm in a position where I can actually start saving now, and that's huge. That's one way to look at it, Karma. Okay, we're going. We got there. Stop kicking me in the back of the head, Winston. This paw right here, buddy. This paw right here, buddy. Wow, R.A. Anubis. That's a lot of kiddos, man. Good for you. I'm good with one, personally. Whoa! Okay, on this one we go over all three of these. That sets up the timing that I want for this right here. Success. Nice. That was good. Your dad was one of 25 children. Dang. My dad came from a family of seven. All right. So here we are. Now you get to switch to doing Dark Worlds. No, you're fine, Karawar. Dark World Cotton Alley, here we come. So Dark Worlds are generally harder. As I said earlier, I think that this is the exception. No, not really, Wuggy. You get what's called a tax deduction for having kids. You can write off some stuff, but really you gotta get like a flat rate per kid. That's kind of how it works. And let me tell you, the cost of children is much higher than your deduction, but it is a deduction nonetheless. What's up, Cabane? Hope you're doing well, man. I don't like this level. It makes me dizzy. It's okay. We're here. We're doing it. There is a cheesy speedrun way to do this, but I've never been able to do it, so we'll just do it the way I know how to. Just crawl my way on over. I goofed that. Wow. I consider my strat on this level pretty safe. I don't know where I'm goofing here. There we go. Glad to hear it, Cabane. The save there. Wow. Wow. I've been pretty great, Cabane. It's been a really busy day. We have one of the people coming up for the Pinball Experience Kickstarter, which closed last November, but gonna spend the weekend with one of the Kickstarter backers and really looking forward to that, but we had to get a lot of stuff done, mostly cleaning. So it's been a busy day. Oh, too much air. Well, the Dark Worlds you can access after you beat the Light World, Mike Maron. They're just called Dark because they're a harder version of the levels. There we go, we got there. Woo! Thanks for the host, Jupiter, appreciate it. But yes, the basic premise is they're harder than normal. Definitely it. Little early on that one. Little early on that one. There we go. Is that so bad? I wouldn't be surprised since Binding of Isaac's basically based off of, well, somewhat based off of Zelda 2. Wouldn't be surprised one bit. Didn't quite make it on that one, okay. Oh, not enough air. The rust is real. Wow. Timing's a bit off. It's been about a month and a half since our last Meat Boy run, and I did not do the Dark Worlds like the previous three times. It's probably like a good 4 or 5 months since I've done Dark Worlds. Shame on me. Oh! Oh! I panicked. Good old Meat Boy. We'll watch the replay after this one, because we can. We've died the most on this level out of any of them. Oh, I touched the salt pile. There we go. Salt is Deadly Meat Boy because he's a boy without skin. If you've ever gotten salt in a wound, it doesn't feel good. Sorry to say I don't plan ahead, Bevins, but look, after y'all will always have a part on the stream somewhere, but I make no guarantees. I have no schedule for games. I can just say normal ever. I'll occasionally plan maybe a cast or two ahead, but past that, no plans. Why did I try to go under there? You're throwing the urns all over the place, sir. There we go. I ruined your life, Sergeant Cortez. My bad. Dota's a great game. I gave up Dota when I started getting into pinball because I realized I did not have time for it. Not at all, Crunch 2. There's actually a lot of really fantastic people in the Dota community. Just have to find them. It's all a matter of what you choose to focus on. If you want to focus on negativity and people being mean, you can certainly do that, but there's plenty of great people everywhere. I would say my experience playing Dota was a very positive one. Nothing wrong with that, Waters Rush. Nothing wrong with that. Oh. Woo! We got there! The way I see it, there's a mute button for a reason. If you want to get all fed up over people being mean or whatever, that's kind of on you. You choose to prioritize that. Sounds harsh, but it's true. It's human nature to focus on negative things over positive things. That is a choice that we all make. What's low priority, Sergeant Cortez? Wow, did I just nail that? I sure did. You could nod on that one, Josh, though. I wish. There we go, that's the jump. I jumped right into it. Why? There we go. Just gotta remember how to do it, you know? Well, I goofed that one. I was an okay golfer, not great. I never put in the time to practice enough to get actually good. I enjoy golfing, though. So there's two ways to approach this level. You can try to get rid of the chargers. There we go, that's good. You can try to get rid of the chargers here, or you can clump them all up like this by jumping over and then going under, jumping over, going under. This is ideal strat right here. It's definitely safest because they all get clumped up in the same spot. You can also try to drag them off the map by jumping up super high. That is also effective, though it doesn't always work. Okay, we're not going to do this level. Now, let me tell you a story. I used to stream with XSplit way back in the day, and that level had a glitch where the blocks would reappear faster than they should, so I never really practiced that level, and I really just haven't gotten around to practicing it, nor do I want to right now. I understand how to do the level, but maybe we'll go back and practice it one day. I find this level to be easier than the Light World variants. Something about going down is easier than going up here. All right, Anubis, have a great one, sir. Have a great one. You know, it's nothing wrong with that, Crunchtooth. I have often said on stream that if I was not a broadcaster, I really wouldn't be playing very many games. I think I'd be watching a lot more Twitch than playing. Not that I don't enjoy playing games, because I do. I just really feel if I was at this point in my life, I wouldn't be playing as many games. I definitely don't enjoy new releases and stuff like that the way that I used to, which is probably to my disservice as a broadcaster, because there's a lot of good opportunities with game releases, but I like what I like, and I don't like what I don't like. Keeping up with hype trains and following game news and stuff like that is just not something I enjoy whatsoever. Woo! Alright, it's Dark World Rapture time. Dark World Rapture is nuts. Have a good one, J.R. Barnes. Take her easy. I definitely enjoyed the bit of COD multiplayer I played. It was pretty good. I still like shooters. I just, I have a hard time streaming shooters. It's very hard to concentrate on chat, which is really a priority for me. Yeah, there you go, Bevan. This is good. I don't have time to play any games off stream, Dark Zombie. And frankly, I'm not a huge fan of the Fallout franchise. I think the Fallout games are great. I really enjoyed my playthrough of 3. Didn't enjoy New Vegas very much. Past that, I haven't really played the franchise. So, like, legit, the only reason I would have played Fallout 4 on release would be to try to get viewers. I just don't do that. I play what I want when I want. It works out good for me. Am I gonna make it? Ooh, yeah, we made it. Just barely. Okay, this is a good kid level. Nice little skippage here. You make a lot of time sacrifices to be a full-time broadcaster, and my own personal video game playing time doesn't exist anymore. Maybe play a little bit of Hearthstone on a given night or something like that. That's really just a few games. I like the Fallout franchise, but I would not say I'm a super fan of it. I'm not super well-versed in it. I really did enjoy my playthrough of 3, but that's about all I can say for it. Okay, here we go. That jump right there, it took me over an hour to learn how to do. Not a fun jump. There's a bandage in here somewhere. There it is. There it is. Oh, balls. Yeah, that's definitely a consideration, Cabane. I usually don't worry about this stuff too much, but definitely, you know, MOBA and shooter markets as a streamer are very saturated already. I mean, you can say the same for Hearthstone. I'm very happy with my Hearthstone streams. I think the audience for it is spectacular. But, you know, it's a very saturated market when you start streaming that. It's not a bad thing. It just means there's a lot more people streaming it. A lot more people streaming it at a high level. Definitely something you have to be conscious of as a broadcaster. Woo! We got it. Okay, we're gonna do this the hard way. The hard way also happens to be the quick way. So there's a little button in between those two saw blades that you need to hit to unlock the door. Yeah, we're gonna get it in one go, just like that. Kid time. Hey, we're making pretty good progress on the Dark Rapture. Not struggling too much at all. It feels good. Oh, I fell down. I fell down. That's cool, Cobain. Jump, 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 jump. I'm doing awesome, Phil. Thanks for asking. Honestly, quite tired, but feeling great. Physically tired, mentally feel awesome. Kid can jump twice. He's a double jump character. So if you touch a wall at all, you gain your two jumps back. Woohoo! Maggot to the toe. Insta-kill. Rampage. Glitch girl, what's happening, lady? What's happening? I goofed that. I goofed it. Now that we've reached the glitch world, it's available for us to play at any time, though. So the hard part is actually just getting the glitch world, since it's a completely random chance. Glitch world done. Nice that we got it on our first pass, so that feels good. Hold on, this is a Meat Boy one, right? Yes. It's a pretty epic skip. That's a long level without the skip. I had that one too. So you gotta get this missile to blow up that little segment at the bottom of the level, which is, hey, just like that. Now let's not goof the rest, huh? What hit me? Yes, the more Dark Worlds you have completed, the higher chance you have of getting Bandage Girl there. Or Glitch Girl, excuse me. We got this! Woo! Too close. Oh yeah, what's the trick here? That's the trick. The bandage is on the far left side attached to this little platform, so... just gotta be careful! Too close. No, I haven't, Cobain. Okay, we got this. I think this is 519, so we're almost done with Dark World Rapture. We'll take a short break after Dark World Rapture. Dark World Hell's pain too. And then we get into not easier, but I think funner levels to play after that. Balls. I missed that one. Hey, thanks for the fishing. It's growing. That's what my beard does. Funny how that works. You don't shave and you get a beard. Incorrect. Oh yeah, we got one more warp zone. I think this is a fun-ish warp zone. They say fun-ish, so I don't think it's a good one. Remember right, it's got cool design. Oh yeah, this is the fanblade one. Balls! This is the fanblade one. Let's see, I think we're about month 3 right now on this beard. Yeah, I think 3 months. Oh yeah, okay. Doo-doo. I was telling people, like, oh, your beard's so sick, dude. It's like, well, you know, all I really did was be lazy and not shave, but thank you. Thank you for complimenting my laziness with long hair and a beard. Because really, that's what it boils down to for me. The act of shaving is annoying, and it upsets my skin, so I stop shaving. And then hair grows out. Pretty cool, huh? I suppose the 2-year challenge is a bit different since we agreed not to grow a beard for the entire, or grow a beard for the entire 2 years, but I mean, I always preferred facial hair before that for that very reason. It's not like I set out to have a great beard or anything. I just said, I don't want to shave anymore. Like, that's really what it boils down to. It's not like I woke up one day and like, I'm gonna have the most epic beard ever. Yeah, that's gonna be me. It's like, no, I don't wanna fucking shave today. I'm done. I'm done. I'm not gonna shave anymore. Well, Stanima, I can tell you that it really is genetics, but I will say this. Since switching to a plant-based diet, my hair has been growing in much thicker and faster. So take that for what you will, but eat your vegetables. Take your vitamins. Past that, you are at the mercy of genetics. Also, my biggest beard growing tip is go buy yourself a little soft bristle brush and scrub your face with soap in the shower. It will basically eliminate that awful itchy phase everybody complains about when they grow beards. Some people can't grow beards, it's just how it is. Well, I apparently missed a bandage somewhere, but you know what? I don't care. We're gonna let that one go. Alright, so we're about to head into Dark World Hell. I'm going to take that break as advertised. I'll be back in 3 minutes or less. Thank you to those Doula ads to play, sports myself. Actually, we used that earlier today for Dapper Time, Sergeant Cortez. We did. The original mustache comb. This is where Dapper Time started. Gotta keep that mustache straight. We'll be right back. I've used Honest Amish Beard Balm. That's pretty good stuff for oils. But really, the main thing for the itchy phase is to scrub your face when your hair is growing in. If you keep your face really clean and exfoliated, you will not have as much itching. When I worked at the country club, they instituted a clean facial hair policy. I didn't have a beard like this then, of course. I had like a goatee. I ended up just shaving. And the GM and my chef would always get mad at me because they said I didn't shave. And I was like, look. It's like, look, I shaved this morning when I woke up. What you don't understand is I don't have a 5 o'clock shadow. I have a 5 o'clock solar eclipse. I literally shaved when I woke up, sir. If you want me to take a break in the middle of dinner rush to shave, I will. But I'd have to shave twice a day if you want it to be any cleaner than this. Whoops. Let's use the kid here. This level is meant for the kid. Oh god, I goofed there. MRI guy 7, thank you for the 28 months of support, man. Much love, partner. Sweet, Glitch Girl twice in a row, nice. I like it. Nice. Glitch level get. Oh, hey, it's this one. I'm already dead, so I hesitated. Woo! Cheers, MRI. Appreciate it, man. Life is good. We'll just play it slow here. Yeah, we'll just play it slow. Yeah, sure. Sure you will, buddy. Oh! You can just stand on that little ledge and then grab the bandage that way, but probably should. One day. So this has historically been a pretty hard level for me. We'll just do it this way. Oh, and then I touched it. Whoopsie daisy. We got it. Alright, this is a kid level 100%. Oh kid, you're so good at the levels you're good at. Okay, this is the one time you use Commander video in 106%, or this is gonna be 105%. The Commander video can float. That's his job, to get to that warp zone. Mission complete, Commander Video. Mission complete. What's up, Matt D? Oh, I know the warp zone I missed. I missed the warp zone in Hell, 418. Flyridge. We'll grab that while we're here. I could have made that one. We'll play it safe, huh? Safety first. This bandage is a real, real jerkaroni pizza. Now this level's a jerkaroni pizza. Not sure how I jumped off the wall there, but that was pretty cool. That was definitely faster than you'd normally be able to do that. Nice. Okay, so we did not get a... Did not get our A-plus here. Yeah, that's an easy one. That's right, I failed on the bandage front. That's right. Ooh, whiffed it. This game, man. This game. That's the kid level. Great use of the kid there. What's up, Leica? I don't know what it is. I always found the Dark World Hell levels to be some of the most fun to play. Dark World Salt Factory is also pretty awesome. Buddy. Let's see what we got going on here. Hell yeah. This beat Hush for the first time. Congratulations, Lay B. That Hush fight is super fun. Also very intense. Woo! Forgot how to do that level. I remembered. Hot diggity dog. One hit a clip. Oh, that's a laser beam, right. Laser beams are cool. Oh, I was way late on that one. I think that little graphical glitch in the background is happening because I'm not at a actual perfect 16x9. I stretched the window out, so it's causing issues in the background. This is an awesome level to use the kit on. This is also where he missed the warp zone on the... Yeah, don't touch the lava, kid. On the first one here. Okay, here we go. There we go. Okay, see if I remember how to do this. I remembered! Yeah, run man! Okay, we need to go back real quick. Or 18 light roll is fly room, which is a really fun warp zone, so good thing. It's been a good 4 or 5 months since I've even attempted this category with me. You made it here just in time. Flylinch actually has a lot of really cool strats for him, but they're tough. Flylinch is a really wonky character to use. We'll probably end up trying to use him on Salt Factory. There's one level where he's highly effective. It is a pretty tough strat, but I enjoy it. Safety net. Such an easy, cheesy skip if you know what you're doing. If you try to do that the way that it's intended, really nightmarish. Alright, hell's done. We're going to the salt factory. Keep it salty. Keep it good. Alright, what's the dealio with this level? Oh, yeah. Whoa there, buddy. Yeah, Bible on Satan should be the only thing that insta-kills you in Isaac. It hurts so good. I can never get too mad with this game. This game is so well designed that anytime you die, it's your own damn fault. The levels never change, the mechanics never change, so it's really, it's on you. How mad can you get? Oh, pretty mad you can get. This game definitely gave me a bad case of controller thumb when I first played it. But as I played it more, you learn to not grip the controller so hard. Your hands don't hurt. Active Ginkgo, thank you for keeping it dapper. Appreciate the 20 consecutive months, sir. Much love, man. I don't know, I used to be a lot more ragey when I was younger, but at the end of the day, it's only a game. Just a game. The most important thing is if I know that I have a threshold in myself, I start getting too frustrated, I stand up and take a break. That's like the best way not to get over frustrated. If you feel yourself approaching that level, just step away for a second. The game's not going anywhere. It's also something I've also got a lot better with being a streamer, because when I first became a streamer, I knew the kind of broadcast I wanted to have. I wanted to have a you know, friendly, relaxing broadcast. So it does not suit my needs as a broadcaster, entertainer, to be, like, super ragey. I personally find rage pretty entertaining, but for my style of broadcast, it's just not gonna fly. Holy crap, I'm doing Light World levels right now. I just realized that. I was like, this looks really familiar. I shouldn't be doing these right now. Okay, this is by far the hardest set of, or the hardest glitch level in the game. Hands down. This level can suck a lemon. We are on Dark Worlds, yes. We're on Dark World Soul Factory, and I've completed Dark World Rapture and Dark World, bad thought there. Rapture and Hell, that's where we're at. Okay, this is a kid level. Kid's very good here. Whoopsie daisy. There we go. All right, Cabane, have a great day at work, sir. We'll catch you later, man. Thanks for stopping by. Always nice to see you. Cabane's one of my original viewers. Before the 2-year livestream challenge. Before I had a career, when I was just doing it for funsies, Cabane was here. Oh hell, I never did content production for funsies. I always wanted to make a job out of it. Yep, there he is. What a good boy. What a good boy. Nice. That's actually a particularly hard level for me to execute. We nailed it. Something later, I believe I made my, account in, like, July of 2011, actually started streaming around October 2011, and then we began the 2-year livestream challenge January 5th, 2012. Come on now. Which you'll flip it floppin'. There we go, that's better. The very first game I ever streamed would be Call of Duty Black Ops. The very first game I began the 2-year livestream challenge with was Star Wars The Old Republic, the MMO. Yeah, we'll just play that one soon. This is an interesting warp zone. What? Do 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 do. I guess I did that backwards. We could have saved a whole second. Runs over. Whoa! That was a wild and crazy guy. What? Okay, we'll go back then. We'll go back then. I understand. That was my bad. Might as well reset right here. No, no, we're not doing it again. It's been a long time since we've done 106%. Cheese and rice, man. I know what I'm doing wrong here. I know exactly what I need to do. Need to do that, and then not die. Whoa! I have been great, Lego. It's been awesome getting back. It was nice to speak to you after the award, and thank you for putting together that awesome video. Just living the dream. Since we got back from TwitchCon, we finally finalized the ability to switch between video game and pinball content seamlessly. So that's a pretty big deal. That's been the only major like change for the broadcast, but. You know, living the dream, man. Yeah, that video was super, super well put together. You guys did a fantastic job on that. I've been doing a couple hours of pinball a night. We're not going to play tonight. I broke everything down. We have maybe the final or last to final person coming up that supported the Kickstarter this weekend. But I've been switching over, and I would love a physical copy of it. Not physical copy, but a digital copy. That'd be awesome if you guys would email it over. I had the link to the video and everything. But yeah, if you want to send me a copy, that'd be awesome. Got my award all framed and stuff. My parents did that for me. Of course. Yeah, we've been doing like 1 to 2 hours of pinball content a night, usually at the end of the broadcast, now that we can seamlessly switch. Generally, switch one machine per week. We've got 3 playable machines right now. Hopefully by mid next year, we'll have the 4th machine back up and running. Got a lot of restoration work left to do. Holy crap, I'm gonna die here. I'm not gonna die here. Woo! Thank Gertie Gumdrops. I really enjoy this all factory. It's like all the coolness of the Rapture Dark World levels with none of the severe frustration. Fly Spirit Game, last November we ran a Kickstarter Lethalfrag's pinball experience to see if there was interest in live pinball streaming on Twitch. That was a pretty smashing success. So we now have the pinball studio, which is why we can play pinball and do the Switch. I don't think that command exists anymore. It's still on Kickstarter, of course, but it's long done and closed. But since the Kickstarter is closed, we've built and now rebuilt the pinball studio. It's pretty much in its ideal setting right now. I think we have like the best environment to stream pinball in, which is awesome. Yeah, there was some interest. And since then, we've seen a huge amount of people stream pinball on Twitch. I think it's really great. I think 2016 is going to be the year for pinball. Okay, this is the fly wrench level I was talking about. Oh no! I'm supposed to go to the other side. Fly wrench! You're so wonky. There we go. There we go. Here's a link to the video, Cabane. I got it, there it is. Yeah, once again, you did a really stellar job on that video. Can't compliment you enough on that. Very well done. Yeah, I think 2016 is going to be the year for pinball. I'll be very honest, pinball is not making me the big bucks, but it's a really important part of my content. I really enjoy playing pinball, I enjoy the hobby, and I enjoy everything about it. It provides me a level of mental stability that I did not have before, because when I quit my job as a cook to pursue the 2-year livestream challenge, I gave up my hobby, gaming, and tried to make it a career, and I did. And then I was left hobbyless, but thanks to that Kickstarter and stuff, we're able to actually share my hobby with the world of Twitch. I think that's really awesome. So my hobby kind of became work again, but that's A-okay by me. I think streaming pinball is awesome. I'm really glad I'm able to do so. Yeah, let me tell you, Ashley didn't make it any easier on me to compose myself. As soon as she saw it, she started bawling. That made me want to cry. And Sacriel was crying over there too. It's tough. Had to man up there for a minute. There we go. Is that so bad? Okay, this level sucks. We're gonna come back with Captain Viridian from VVVVV. I think pinball becoming more popular on Twitch is not, I mean, maybe I, you know, maybe I innovated something, but at the same time, I think it's gonna be a group effort. Everybody's gonna have to come together and stream pinball, which has been happening. I mean, the amount of people streaming pinball is like over 50 now. And when I started, I think there's Papa TV, which has the best collection, and they run the Pinball World Championships. As far as individual people streaming pinball, I think there's well over 30 now, which is awesome. Yeah, Sacriel's awesome. I always try to hang out with Sacriel if we go to cons and stuff. Laika, have a great night, sir. Thanks for stopping by. Appreciate your time, man. Okay, we'll be back to 319. I like to do the Dark Worlds backwards rather than work your way forwards. So you work your way forward, you start with the easier levels, and you work to extremely difficult. And this way, you get to kind of have fun towards the end of your run, which is nice. I'll take it. This is a kid level, at least for the warp zone. What warp zone is this? Oh god. It's this one. Do, do, do. Yeah, definitely, Matt D. This game definitely hits the mark on difficulty for me. There's really no point in this game where you're like, damn it, this is unfair. Even when I was first playing it, there was no point where you're like, this is super unfair. It's like, okay, this is really hard. You know, honestly, Wonko T. Sane, I'll tell you this right now. My repair and restoration streams are some of my highest viewed and were some of my highest pinball numbers. A little bit different now that we have the seamless switch, but I think there's a lot of interest in repair and restoration. Especially early on, those were some of my most successful streams, for sure. Like when I was pulling apart the Next Generation and working on the Atom family and stuff like that, definitely lots of interest. Balls. After this weekend, no more excuses. Well, I have stuff to do this weekend, of course, but next weekend, the weekend after this, I'm getting back on getting the Addams Family prep for clear coating. Hippo Taco, thank you for keeping it damper. Appreciate these 7 consecutive months. Okay, we're gonna try to cheese this level. Oh wait, I'm doing this too early. It worked out. The only cheap hobby is sleeping. Amen to that, Matt D. What? Oh yeah, you went through with the flight 2000, Wonko. That's nice. New machines, always exciting. Yeah, okay, Wiz, sure. I am in Pacific Standard Time. Devins? Oh yeah, drag a bug over here. Right. Oh, there's still a bandage over here I can't get yet. Okay, got it. Got it, we're good. What? Okay. Flew off the map there. Fair enough. Fair enough. Wow, that was a near-death experience. Yeah, that seems like a pretty fair price, even if it needs work, and you said it did, I mean. 200, that's a fair price for a pinball machine. What year was the Flight 2000 release, Wonko? I am exactly the same, Space Cadet. Exactly the same. I still drive a beat up old used Toyota, and I'll probably buy another beat up used old Toyota when this one's done. The car for me is a way to get from point A to point B. Cars are a cool hobby though. I don't know why I decided to do this level as the kid, but it worked out apparently. Maybe. I guess it's different too. I don't really need a car for much. If you need a car for a lot, it's like one of those things. Like if you sit in the computer a lot, you're gonna want to get a nice PC chair. It's kind of one of those things. I don't really drive very many places, so a car becomes less important. Nice Waters Rush. Thanks for watching. Man, that Hall of Fame induction is definitely going to be one of the top moments of my life, I think, for the rest of it. It was a wonderful moment. Also unexpected, which made it even better. We're going places. This is such a fun level once you know how to do it, which is just hippity hoppity your way up the side. Oh yeah, fun song. I remember that one. That was a cool little moment. That was a fun one. Alright, now I get to do Dark World Forest, which is just fun. It's diddly darn fun. We'll just take the slow way. Quick way always gets me killed and only saves about a half second. Oh, I missed a bandage there, I think? Maybe? No. Wait, where's the bandage? I think there's a bandage on this level? Am I tripping right now? I must be tripping. No, there it is. Great card, Wiz. Great card. What a generous fellow you are to yourself. Hardware is in such an amazing place right now. The technology we have access to is just, like, so cool. So cool. Oh, hey, Glitch Girl. How you doing? How you doing? Oh, how you doing? All right, I'll use the double jump character. Fine. Warp zone here, if I remember right. Yep.
Warp zone!
Easy money. Big money, no whammies. What? That happened to me. I did that to myself. Much better. So much easier than those later warp zones. Oh my goodness, it's Floaty frickin' 3000! Little hand to you, Floaty! Welcome back to the Dapper, the creator of so many absolutely freaking amazing photoshops for the channel. Great to see you, Floaty. Thanks for being here, man. It's beautiful. Love you, sir. The man, the myth, the legend. Bloody frickin' 3000. What a legend. So many good photoshops. So many. What am I trying to do with my life? That was not a smart play, sir. That was a smart play. Oh, thank you, Floaty. I guess the feeling's mutual. I'm okay with that. I do appreciate you, though, sir. Wow, I nailed that. That was good. That never happens. Alright, so we didn't get Glitch World here, so we're gonna grab that real quick, then we're gonna go do the end Dark World, that is. So here we're killing ourselves trying to get Glitch Girl to show up. That is it. Don't need A pluses on the Dark Worlds, Mike Marin. It does not count towards completion at all. The reason you need A pluses in Meat Boy is to unlock the Dark Worlds. Once you have the Dark Worlds unlocked, there's no balls. There's no reason to get A pluses. If you're missing an A plus for completion, you'll know it because you won't have the Dark World available to you. But I appreciate you pointing it out, because Lord knows I miss stuff in this game all the time. So good looking out. Alright, cool. So we got Glitch World there. Do we have Glitch World here? I think so. No? Okay, what's the good one to do it here? I think it's 7. Johnny's Cage is the one we want. Indeed, Cobain. I've watched it a couple. It's hard to watch. Like, it really is a nostalgia bomb, that Hall of Fame induction video. So many memories over the past 4 years. I'm really thankful for what I have now, though. I have a lot less stress in my life than I did during the challenge. And I frankly think it translated over the broadcast. I feel the broadcast is a lot more positive and healthy now. Yeah, you gotta build the safety net to fall on before you take the huge risk, would be my advice, Rock Demon. Or at least having, you know, something in place. Gotta have something to fall back on. Alright, what's up? Do we do the Salt Factory one? I just can't remember now. I just don't remember. Yeah, I feel the same way, Oshinomo. I do think the best parts of my career are definitely ahead of me. Not that we have not had some really spectacular things happen so far in my career, but I really do feel like I'm just coming into my own as an entertainer. A lot of the two-year challenge is trying to, you know, figure that stuff out. Angel King, thank you for keeping it damper. Appreciate the 10 consecutive months. And then the next 2 years after the challenge are kind of like trying to figure out, you know, what happiness looked like for me and what I wanted out of life. Oh yes, I did send the lasers. Thank you. You're absolutely right on that. Yeah, Postloggle, I went back and watched that original video where I announced I was going to do the two-year challenge, and the comments on that video are full of just, get a fucking job, you loser. Homeless donate hunter, stuff like that, and I'm not going to lie, it feels pretty good. It feels pretty good now, knowing that I actually made it. Well, I proved all those people wrong. And I don't make a living off of donations. I make a living off of support. Which feels good, man. AK Black, thank you for keeping it damper. Appreciate the 9 consecutive months. I am not a vindictive person at all, but it feels good to prove people wrong sometimes. Especially when people tell you you can't do something, or you're making a mistake, or you're gonna fuck up your life. And you come out on top. Feels good. AK Black, thank you for keeping it damper. Appreciate the 9 consecutive months. Much love. I don't think there's anything worse that I hate worse than being told I can't do something or I'm not capable. That's definitely tops up there for me, so. It was motivation for a long time, honestly. I mean, that was definitely a huge motivator for me. No ill will towards anybody that told me I couldn't, but I definitely took that and used it as motivation. One of the reasons I don't get mad at people online, well, I've certainly had weak moments where I did, but I used to be a giant troll. Like, I used to be an asshole online, so I know all about it, and I know about being in a bad place mentally. So you can never feel bad or, you know, get really mad at people because you've never had to live a day in their shoes, and you just don't know. Certainly had plenty of points in my life where I was probably not the best person. That was partly due to my own fault and partly due to circumstances. But then, you know, you grow up and you get a different perspective on things. So, you gotta keep it in perspective. You never know what's on the other side of that comment. You don't know what life situation or whatever. You don't know anything about that person. They could be legitimately upset at things in their life, and they take it out on you, and that's fine. It's kind of something you have to accept and not take personally. Oh, I was a massive troll. I was a good one, too. I can roll with the best of them. I just don't. Have a great one, Mellow Scar. No, it is Little Fishing. I think my stream has a very specific target audience, is what it is. I don't want 30,000 viewers on my stream. That'd be really stressful. I honestly feel as if my stream, for the most part, is targeted not by intention, but just by my nature, is targeted towards people that are introverted, which is why we have slower chat. I'm sure we do have plenty of extroverts that watch, but I do feel like I'm a very introverted person. And I understand what an introvert wants. You don't want to talk to people at the end of the day or have anything crazy going on. When you get done with your work or whatever, you want to sit back, relax, and enjoy. That's all I ever wanted when I got off of work, was just to chill. So I try to provide that environment that I always wanted to have when I was, you know, doing whatever. Oh, I got squished by the door. That's a painful way to go, man. Do, 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 do. Lurkers are the lifeblood of any stream. This is true. Why did I double jump there? Oh, because I want to die, right. Yeah, it really is, Wizmander. Like, that's all I—that's all I wanted to do when I ever got off of working kitchen. I just wanted to chill. I didn't want to go out and party. I didn't want to go talk to anybody. I didn't want to hang out with friends. I just wanted to chill. That's kind of what I thought when I first started streaming. Like, if I can create a good environment for people to chill, we can make it good. Now, actually making that happen, much harder than I thought. Very stressful. We got there. God bless. No, never, Seal Terror. Never. Good thing, too. That was actually not JTV, that was after Twitch came out. A lot of streamers switched over to own TV and then never ended up getting paid, so... But as I have always stated on my stream, Twitch TV has provided me with every opportunity to succeed. I would never leave this site just because the grass looked greener on the other side. Or I was offered more money or whatever. This is my home. The people here enabled me to succeed, and I would never leave just because I wanted more money. I don't do this for money. I'm grateful that I make the money I do and I'm able to actually start saving some for my future now after 4 years. But I really do this because I enjoy entertaining and I really enjoy doing this. The paycheck at the end of the day is just a bonus to this. Plenty of people won't believe that and that's fine, but I am not a monetarily driven person. I like to achieve things and accomplish things and put out good feels. If I do that, I feel accomplished, and that's what makes me happy. Making other people happy makes me happy, not making money or having nice things. Thank you, Nora. Do, Oh, balls, I missed my jump. I missed my jump! Did I survive? I survived. Cool. Yeah, that whole own thing was a pretty big bummer, because a lot of people did leave to go over there, and they were promised more money or whatever, and just never got paid. Pretty harsh, man. Definitely Wizmander. I mean, I have invested an astronomical amount into the stream and the pinball studio and all that stuff. And we're finally at a point where I have everything I need and it's stable and I can start saving for the future. And that's a very good feeling. Very good feeling. My dad, though, always like, dude, I don't want to spend this much. He's like, just invest back in your business. Invest back in the business. Just keep investing in the business. Keep investing in your business. So we did. It worked out. Balls. Duh! Awesome, Cobain. That's great to hear. He was Wizmander. He is definitely a very successful business owner in his time. I can gladly thank not only my dad, but my mom for teaching me a lot about running a business and also teaching me what it means to be self-employed. I think without their guidance, this whole broadcast would be in a much different place. And the whole integrity thing, my dad's a very hard worker. I watched him work my entire life. Definitely taught me the value of work ethic and integrity, you know, letting people know that you're going to do what you say and be where you want to be, or be where you tell people you're going to be. It's a really good way to look at it, Rock Demon, because at the end of the day, you have to be satisfied with your content. Mr. Dude McPerson Man, thank you for keeping a damper for the past 6 months, sir. Appreciate it. No, honestly, my dad's a huge inspiration to why I'm here. Pretty incredible guy. He dropped out of college one credit shy of graduating to open his own business, or actually to acquire a business from somebody else. And he made it work. That and the entire time he was going to school, he was working two jobs and flipping houses with my mom to save up to buy the business. He really puts me to shame as far as work ethic goes. He is definitely the hardest working person I know, myself included. Nope, he never did steal tear. He bought the business and never looked back. They ran a patent drafting company, Waters Rush. All right, this is it. This is the urn. Hey, we made it through there. Nice. The timing was off on that, which is why I was surprised. Doo, 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 doo. Hey, thank you, Mr. Dude, McPherson Man. Appreciate your time here, sir. Nice. Let's see where I think I missed a couple things, but you know, that's okay. We're gonna call it 106%. We're gonna call it it. 382 deaths. 105%? Not too bad. I'll call it. You know, I have it, Mr. Rails. I don't have terribly big hands, and this controller has always fit my hands really nicely. It's got that nice feel to it for me. Even the PlayStation controller does not feel quite right, but 106% with an asterisk. There we go. Almost 106%. I'll take it. Alright, everybody, I will go ahead and apologize. It is my goal to end at 3 a.m. nightly. However, we have a very important day coming up tomorrow, and I am incredibly busy this weekend. I had an absolutely amazing time tonight. We had a really great week of streaming. I felt not only the chat, but myself, I felt very positive and energetic this week. And we're going to rally that into next week. We'll start a new Isaac streak next week. More than likely, as well as a few other things. So I want to thank everybody for your time this week, coming out to watch. Had an absolutely wonderful time. Cannot wait to come back and do it again on Monday. Cortland R., thank you for keeping it dapper. Appreciate the year of support. It's 3 a.m. somewhere, but it's not 3 a.m. here, which is my goal. But I got a really busy day tomorrow, and I appreciate your guys' understanding. We'll be back and at it on Monday, 7 p.m. Pacific. See you there. Until then, keep it dapper and be good to each other. That's all I got for tonight. Frag out. You know, in fact, let's see if there's somebody we can host tonight. I think that's a good idea. I often forget to host, and I like to host at least a couple times a week. Yeah, I'm going to host Mr. Night Affinity. We hosted him a couple nights ago, but I think he runs a pretty solid broadcast. He's currently at 30-0 streaking on Eden, so I hope you guys enjoy his content. He'll probably break the game some point tonight. He likes to do that. Have a wonderful night, everybody. Keep it dapper and be good to each other.